Where the fuck is my chalk, my boy? Ah, there it is.
Oh.
Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. As you might have noticed already, I'm really into serious stuff. Pun definitely intended. Hello, my boys. Today we are going to derive yet another integral representation of the Bessel problem today. This quirky sum running from 1 to infinity of the reciprocal of all the natural numbers squared, basically, without zero. Yeah, that's what we are going to do today. We have already derived one integral representation of this infinite series. That was the video, an integral with a surprising result. Yeah, but today we are going to derive yet another one using basically multivariable calculus, a little double integral. So let us go ahead and get started. First, I would like to take a look at a little function, basically, with respect to two variables, namely, I'm going to call it x times t to the pth power over 1 minus x times t. Okay, might not seem too, I don't know, spectacular, looks quite funny, but here's the cool thing. I don't want to talk about Taylor series in more than one dimension. I just want to make use of the fact that we can turn stuff into the geometric series, actually. Namely, if our absolute value of x minus t is between 1 and negative 1, strictly, then we can actually turn this into, well, the geometric series down here. So we have x times t to the pth power times the sum running from, well, let's say k equals to 0 to infinity of, okay, this is x times t to the kth power. We can play around a little bit with this to turn this into a sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity. With respect to this sum, this is just a constant, so we can bring this to the inside and we can turn this into, well, let's put the exponents together, x to the p plus k power times t to the p plus k power. Like I said, we want to turn this into a double integral. So, why not integrate with respect to t at first and on the inside with respect to x and see what we actually get. Let's say we have an integral I now, and that's the integral from 0 to 1. Because we need something in our interval of validity for this series to actually converge, and let's notice that t from 0 to t to 1 of the integral from x to 0 to x equal to 1 of this function here, basically, x times t to the pth power over 1 minus x times t, integrated with respect to x at first and then with respect to t. Now we can just plug this new definition in. I'm going to leave this t equals to something and x equals to something out of the way. We know the order of integration by those differentials right here. So integral from 0 to 1 of the integral from 0 to 1. Oh, that's quite a beautiful integral sign right here. And then we have the sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity of x to the p plus k power, t to the p plus k power, integrated with respect to x, integrated with respect to t. The integrand right here is strictly positive all the damn time on x, meaning we can actually use Papafubini to interchange this limit and this limit, namely sum and integral. Then we have the sum in between those integral signs. Same argumentation here, t is strictly positive all the time on this interval, so let's interchange this sum also with this integral, meaning we can bring this whole sum to the outside, meaning we are going to end up with sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity of integral from 0 to 1. Integrand strictly positive on t, meaning we can actually Fubini this shit. What that also means, we can just, that's once again just an interchange of limits. What you can also say is that our inner integral with respect to x isn't actually with respect to our t. So with respect to x, our t to the p plus k power is just a constant. So why not bring this t into here and also this differential? We are using Papafubini here just because stuff is strictly positive, those integrands. So At first, we are going to evaluate the integral from 0 to 1 of t to the p plus k power integrated with respect to t, and then the integral from 0 to 1 of x to the p plus k power integrated with respect to x. And integrating polynomials is really quite easy. Everyone knows how to do this. So now we have a sum running from 0 to infinity, our famous infinity boy. Okay, this is going to give us, I'm going to write it here, 1 over p plus k plus 1 to the times t to the p plus k plus 1 power, and this right here analogously 1 over p plus k plus 1 times t to the p plus k plus 1 power. And that's not a t, it's supposed to be an x because we are integrating this x right here. Those multiplied together is 1 over this chunk squared, and then we have t times x, but with the same power respectively right here. Okay, so let's turn this into 1 over p plus k plus 1, but squared, and then we have t times x to the p plus k plus 1. And don't forget to apply your limits from 0 to 1. We do in normal case have two limits, but stuff is going to vanish. If we apply the limit on t, where this is 0, it's just going to vanish. All those 0 parts, same should be with the x's right here. And if we plug 1 into here, well, 1 to some power is just 1 all the time. So that really doesn't matter to us. So this right here is going to evaluate to 1 just. And what are we going to get in the end? We are going to get that our integral I is now nothing but a sum running from k equals to 0 to infinity of 1 over p plus k plus 1 but squared. Why not make a little change of index? For example, let n be equal to k plus 1. Okay, then our sum runs from, okay, if we plug 0 into this change of index, well, n is going to run from 1 to infinity of 1 over p plus n but squared. And here's a little special case. Why not let p be equal to 0? Then our integral I is now nothing but, you can give it a little index, for example p, for example, I really don't care. Then our I is actually going to turn into sum running from n equals to 1 to infinity of, well, 1 over n squared, which is nothing but pi squared over 6. But we also know what our integral is equal to. If we apply this limit right here, p being equal to 0, x times t to the 0 of power is just 1. So that's actually also equal to the double integral from 0 to 1 of the integral from 0 to 1 of, well, let's say, I'm going to put the differentials to the side there, 1 over 1 minus x times t integrated with respect to x integrated with respect to t. Yeah, and this is it. This is actually our integral representation of the Bessel problem. Yet another one. There are probably many more of those. But yeah, I think that's quite cool. That's something I wanted to show to you guys. And here's just a little remark. So let me get my chart back once again for a second. This thing right here is actually equal to, I fucking hate this, okay? That's supposed to be a zeta of 2, okay? That's the Riemann zeta function. Where, whatsoever, zeta of s, I haven't really practiced that, is nothing but the sum running from, well, k equals to 1 to infinity of 1 over, let's say, x to the s power. Okay, this is our Riemann zeta function, and zeta of 2 is nothing but our Bessel problem with this integral representation. And I want to work with this, or rather this right here, as a parameterized integral in the very next video. So don't miss that, I guess. If you did enjoy this video, please like, subscribe, recommend channel. If you like, if you want to support channel a bit more, buy those t-shirts I created, support channel on Patreon, whatsoever. And I guess I'm wishing you a flammable day, and up until the next video. Yeah, have a flammable day. That was the wrong order. Sometimes I'm mixing stuff up. I really don't have a strict outro. I'm just improvising all the time. See ya.